So the changes and the trends which are likely to impact London market brokers are regulation. As we can see today, the Brexit situation provides a degree of uncertainty, and therefore the changes in the regulation as we move away from the EU will be something which will affect the market as a whole, but also for brokers and how they interact with their clients. Innovation, so a lot of changes in the way that technology and the impacts of that technology has on people's lives will affect the way the insurance needs to provide products and services to be able to insure against those risks. And finally, competition. The London market needs to become more competitive in both product risk offering and also in terms of price. A lot of that is associated with the cost of transaction of doing business. So a lot of the changes that the Lloyd's Blueprint is proposing is aimed to become more efficient and more effective so that the whole market can become more cost efficient and more competitive against emerging markets from overseas.
In terms of the broking landscape, I think, again, the demands for increased technology and increased analytics within the business is driving consolidation. I think for brokers to be able to afford to move to where they need to be, I think many smaller brokers and certainly even medium-sized brokers will start to look to see how they can consolidate. And I think over 2020 and 2021, we're going to see much more consolidation in the broking space. So what I think we're going to see as well are the industry leaders of the past setting up greenfield legacy-free businesses that take advantage of all these new technologies that enable them to work in far more efficient manners, looking at data, bringing analytics to places perhaps where it hasn't been brought before, and delivering superior services and superior solutions to clients that the incumbents are finding very difficult to do with their legacy platforms. And finally, I think we're going to see the emergence of much more integrated MGA solutions out there, which could well be competing for the wholesale broker space. One notable event was towards the end of last year, Syndicate 2288 was set up by Victor, the MGA arm of Marsh McLennan. So now they're a completely vertical organisation. They have their own Lloyd's capacity and distribution and product. Now that's going to enable them to evolve and deliver products very quickly, very effectively. And innovation for that business now is fairly frictionless, as they have capacity to deliver the solutions they want. And brokers are going to need to think about how they evolve their own product strategies to meet challenges such as Victor.